Welcome to the Rich Club channel. Before viewing, please like the video, write a comment and subscribe to the channel. Thanks, let's go! In this video, you will learn the story of the position of the richest people in the world, their relationship to each other and what we can accept from them in the future. Elon Musk and Jeff Bezos are two billionaires with big pockets, successful businesses and grand ambitions. Bezos is the king of e-commerce. Musk is a titan of technology, and yet, that the two have crossed paths more often than they probably would have liked. The heat between them burns with the temperature of the rocket fuel, despite the fact that Bezos and Musk are engaged in completely different spheres.
Finally, you're obviously a very competitive person. You're competing with the likes of Jeff Bezos
Jeff who?
Elon Musk responded in an interview, Jeff Bezos is the CEO and founder of Blue Origin, a manufacturer of innovative aerospace equipment that wants to reduce the cost of space exploration. On the other hand, Elon Musk is the CEO and founder of SpaceX, a manufacturer of innovative aerospace equipment that also wants to make space exploration cheaper. I'm sure you understand that this case can cause some friction between them. But the situation didn't always resemble a ring where Musk in the left corner and Bezos in the right. In fact, in 2004, they even had lunch together while discussing missile system architectures. He tried to protect Jeff from the mistakes that SpaceX had already made in developing rocket engines, Elon recalled. It's notable that the reason for the competition between Bezos and Musk was even the tax benefits that large American corporations regularly receive from the local authorities. With their help, the leaders of individual cities or entire states are trying to convince the top of management of corporation to place production or even headquarters on their territory. A striking example of the work of such system. The company Boeing in 2013 received from the state of Washington about $8.7 billion to expand production in Seattle, the largest city in the state, with an increase in the number of jobs. A year later, Elon Musk took advantage of this scam, receiving $1.3 billion in tax breaks from the state of Nevada to build an electric car factory. They say this really angered Bezos, who instead of receiving benefits from the state of Washington and Seattle, only constant criticism. They say that because of the presence of the Amazon headquarters, life in the city has become much more expensive. Both SpaceX and Blue Origin are likely to have a big impact on the rocket launch market in the next few years, says James Broger, managing partner of Seraphim Capital, a London-based venture capital fund. His foundation is investing in a space company. Broger predicts that SpaceX and Blue Origin will compete head-on. Both companies want to launch satellites that provide cheap broadband internet around the world, and the wars between Musk and Bezos are likely to range for many more years, the expert adds. According to Broger, SpaceX is currently more authoritative than Blue Origin, since it has been fulfilling government orders for many years. SpaceX launched government satellites and delivered cargo to the International Space Station. And of course, he adds, they have just completed a landmark mission to bring American astronauts to the ISS, making the beginning of an era of commercial human space flights. The fortune of the founder of SpaceX and Tesla, Elon Musk, has increased to $188.5 billion, according to data from the Bloomberg Billionaires Index. Thus, Musk beat Amazon founder Jeff Bezos by $1.5 billion and became the richest man in the world. At the same time, back in November, Musk's fortune was estimated at $127.9 billion. In total, over the past year, the entrepreneur has become rich by $150 billion. Before that, the list of the richest people in the world since 2017 was headed by Bezos. Third place in the list of the richest men remains from Microsoft founder Bill Gates. On November 5th, it became known that the richest people in the world earned $34 billion. Amazon CEO Jeff Bezos' bill increased by $10.5 billion. Facebook CEO Mark Zuckerberg is $8 billion rich. at 6% rise in Tesla shares earlier in a week lifted the value of its sales stocks and options by $10 billion, bringing his net worth to about $191 billion. A more modest rise of less than 2% lifted Bezos' Amazon stock by about $3 billion, putting his net worth at $187 billion. Bloomberg's real-time billionaires tracker currently shows that Bezos is still ahead of Musk by about $3 billion. But the tracker is not updated until the end of the trading day. According to Forbes real-time tracker, Musk and Bezos were still $18 billion apart the close of trading on Wednesday, after Bezos lost $4.3 billion in the value of his Amazon shares. Another rise in Tesla shares on Wednesday lifted Musk's net worth by $4.1 billion to $165.4 billion, according to the Forbes calculation. But Forbes doesn't seem to be giving Musk credit for the value of the options he received in 2020 to buy an additional 33.6 million Tesla shares. Musk is also a major shareholder and CEO of SpaceX. Also, SpaceX is privately owned, so its value doesn't fluctuate as much as Tesla. Bezos' stake in Amazon shares rose by $75 billion in 2020 to $173.3 billion, given the huge sales growth caused by the coronavirus pandemic. But that was nothing compared to Musk's holdings at Tesla. The 170 million Tesla shares it already owns have risen in value by $106 billion over the course of 2020, as the stock soared 743% over the course of the year. The value of his stock options he held at the start of the year increased by $14.2 billion, while the new options he received during the year as a part of his pay package had a value of $21.5 billion at the end of the year. After Musk overtook Bezos in the list of the richest people in the world, he changed the fixed post to Twitter page, placing there an entry made in 2018, in which he promised to give a half of his fortune to build a city on Mars. Business Insider notes, Musk himself said that he decided to sell all the property for the colonization of Mars. In fact, I will have almost no property left with the monetary value of the company's shares, he said. Earlier, Musk said that by 2050 he accepted to build a city on Mars with a population of 1 million people. I think you understand the logic. The quarrel between Musk and Bezos stretched for decades. Sometimes it's serious, sometimes harmless, but in case we'll definitely take more and more steps turns. Both entrepreneurs have a huge weight, both have capital for insurance. Today, they share not only the sphere of space research, but also the sphere of internet and autonomous electric vehicles. Probably now, they will face each other more often. And believe it or not, this could be great news for all of us. And not just because it's all pretty funny. Competing at these levels means progress and speed. Bezos is pushing Musk, Musk is pushing Bezos, and new technologies will eventually get to us faster than they could, and will be better and possibly even cheaper. How do you think? We should now wait for Neuralink from Amazon. Write it in a comment. It was Rich Club channel. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and click to the bell.